Hello, welcome to SuNi Art. This is SuNi. 大家好，欢迎来到 SuNi Art， 我是 SuNi。 今天想跟大家分享的呢，就是这个一笔画，我们的英文叫做 One Stroke Painting。 今天today I want to share with you this very simple painting we call One Stroke Painting. One Stroke Painting actually is very easy to learn, especially for beginner who just started to learn for art painting.一笔画呢，其实对初学者来说呢，是蛮容易上手的。你只要学会基本的一些笔法，然后呢，你就每一天的练习，你需要很多的练习。你练习过后呢，其实你掌握了笔法，你就可以画很多很多不同的花卉。So one stroke painting is easy to learn, especially for beginner. Once you know the stroke, you have to practice, of course, every day. Once you master the stroke, actually you canpaint a lot of different flora, different flowers. Okay, today I want to share with you this very simple painting, iris. 今天要跟你分享的呢，就是这个鸢尾花。Okay, this one is using one stroke method, 使用一笔画画出来的，所以是蛮简单的，只是有你要学一些基础的笔法。这个笔法呢，其实在我其他的视频我已经教了，就是逗点的笔法。 And this stroke, we use only one stroke for this painting, is comma stroke. And this comma stroke actually I already share in some of my other video. Okay, you can check my description section. I already share the link there, you can have a look there.我在我的描述栏呢也放了那个连接，你可以再连接，你可以点连接进去练习这个逗点笔法。今天呢，我也会教你一个也是用一笔画画出来的这个蝴蝶。 Today I also will teach you how to use one stroke to paint this simple butterfly. Okay, you can use different colors. Okay, not necessary have to use this color. 你可以用不同的颜色画这个蝴蝶。OK, 所以今天呢也会用一笔画的方式来画这个蝴蝶。我们来看一下这个笔，我很喜欢用椭圆笔来彩绘。 OK, 所以呢我用的这支椭圆笔呢是2号的，这个牌子的2号。当然不同牌子呢它的型号会不一样，它的尺寸大小也会不一样。还有我会用一支线笔，就是这两支笔。Today's project, I'm going to use this filbert brush. Most of my students and friends, they know that I like to use filbert brush. So different brand of filbert brush, actually their size will be different. You can use number 2 or number 6 or number 4. 你可以选择用2号、6号或者是4号，我觉得4号会比较适合，因为它不会很大也不会很小。So this one is around number 4, okay? You can try number 4. Or actually this one, this brand is from Korea, is number 2. But if you use other brand, usually this size is quite big. It's around number 4, okay? Number 4. Then also a liner brush. This decorative painting is very fun that also very useful that we can paint on different surfaces.家事彩绘很吸引人的地方呢，就是其实它可以画在不同的素材上面。只是今天呢，我会分享画在这个纸上面，因为我就比较容易，我不用再上色打底。Okay, so only that my demo I will show on a piece of paper, but actually you can paint on different surfaces. I just want to save the time, no need to do the base coating. You can paint like this one. I paint on a glass bottle. It's on a glass.这个呢就是我画在玻璃上的 ，OK， 当然画在玻璃上，你可以选择，你可以购买个玻璃颜料。Paint on the glass, you can use a glass paint. OK, they have special enamel paint or special glass paint, 会有不同的颜料。然后我也画在这个木质的这个盘子上面。And also, you can paint on this. This one actually is a wooden plate. You can also choose to paint on this wooden plate.And also, I painted this one on a ceramic mug. 这个呢是画在瓷器上的，这个是我画的。OK, 所以呢，你不一定是画在纸上或者是木器上，其实你也可以画在很多不同的素材。So, you can paint on different surfaces as you happy, any surface actually. OK, this one is on a canvas. 这个是画在这个帆布袋上。OK.And then this one is on the wood. 这个是画在一个盒子上。 a wood box. It's a storage box. I painted this flower. Okay? 这个是画在一个木盒子。Okay? 所以你可以选择画在不同的木器或者不同的素材，只是今天我的分享是画在纸上。 Only that today's sharing I painted on a paper. Okay, what else that you need to prepare? Okay, all my painting show here is using limited palette. I use only from here, 16 color set. 我全部我的彩绘，我分享的彩绘呢的作品呢，都是从我都是用这个 SuNi Art 的16色这个套装组里面选出来的颜色，所以学生就比较容易，不需要一下购买太多的颜色。So easier for beginner who started to learn, for art painting, you need only 16 colors. This color set is enough for you to paint many, many projects. Okay. So today's, other than that, you need to prepare a kitchen towel. I like to use this kitchen towel. Actually, it's a cotton. 我其实蛮喜欢用这个，其实它是不是纸巾哎。它其实是好像布这样子的，它不容易烂，而且可以重复使用。And this one can be used repeatedly. Actually, after you wash, still can be used. And also, you have to prepare your palette paper. 也要准备这个调色纸。Okay, the color for today, I am using. 今天用的颜色呢 ，purple diodes purple, moss green, pine green, bright yellow, and white color.就会用到紫色、浅青、深青、苔藓青，这个是松绿、苔藓绿、松绿、亮黄、白色。OK， 就是这几个颜色。Then you have to prepare this brush tub also. We call brush tub. OK， 这个你也要准备的呢，就是这个洗笔筒。洗笔筒呢，其实有分哦。我先把这个清干净来给你看。This one is brush tub. I will show you how to use this one. Okay, this brush cleaner or brush tub, they divided into three different places, compartment like that. As you can see, here actually for you to wash the brush, especially sometimes the paint will start here. Then it's very hard to clean. Then you can clean like this.Then here will be very clean. You can clean all the paint that stuck here. 这个洗笔筒呢，我们会分成三个部分。这个呢，就是给你有时候颜料呢，它很喜欢，很容易呢就把它藏在这里，有没有？很多颜料会藏在这里，久了呢，这支笔就会坏了，有没有？所以这个呢，它设计的结构呢，主要是给我们很容易的清洗，这样子把它清洗。有没有？然后这边呢就会比较干净，然后呢我们再在这边呢再把我们剩余的颜料再清洗干净。 After you wash here, so here the water will be dirty, then we will still washing here to make the brush much cleaner, clean, okay? But after that, last time we very used to use, I'm very used to use this brush tub, we call brush tub.以前呢，我刚开始学的时候呢，其实我们很习惯用这个洗笔筒来洗笔。然后呢，我就去，其实我每一年都出国上课，每一年我都到国外去学习新的东西，都是跟一些很有名的老师。Then after that, I go to study every year with a lot of teachers, painting teacher.Then, from there, my teacher told me, most of the teacher can say, they are not using this brush tub anymore. Because they found that this brush tub, when you clean like this, actually you will spoil the brush, you will spoil the hair. So some of the teacher, they are no more using this brush tub. They just clean here. They never use here anymore. But,Just this one is just depends, okay? Sometimes I still used to use here to clean my brush. 然后我出国上课呢，就很多老师跟我说，他们已经没有再使用这个洗笔筒来洗笔了。主要的原因呢，就是当你这样子洗笔，你一直刮的时候呢，其实你会那个毛呢，这个毛呢，其实是会很伤。 很容易耗损，很容易坏掉，所以呢就开始有很多老师开始就没有用这个洗笔筒了，只是这样子把它清干净就可以了。然后如果有颜料储存在这里的颜料呢，我们都会这样子抓着把它洗干净。 If the paint stuck here, we will just wash like this. Okay, every time you have toclean after some painting, after some time you have to remember to clean it. 所以你每画了一下呢，你要记得把它这样子清干净。但不是每一个老师，还有一些人呢，好像我有时还是习惯 会喜欢用这个洗笔筒的这里呢把它清干净，都是习惯了。 OK, but sometimes I still so used to clean with here, but some of my teacher they really disencouraged me to use this brush topOK, 只是有一些老师，每一个老师的风格都不一样，都没有说对与错，只是一些老师他们就觉得笔很贵嘛，因为然后你的笔你时常这样子用呢，它就很容易耗损。 OK, if you always use like that, then the hair will spoil very easily, and also because the brushes are very expensive, then longer, then the brush will become less and less, then it will spoil easily. So it's just up to you, I just share with you, OK, just up to you whether you want to use this one or you just clean like that.所以呢，这个只是我跟你的分享，你要怎样使用呢？其实是纯粹很个人的 ，OK？ 你可以选择你喜欢的方式 ，OK？ 当然，不同的老师都有不同老师的风格和方式使用，都没有对与错，就是看你个人你习惯的方式 ，OK？ 就是这样。所以呢，我现在呢，有时我也会使用这边，有时我习惯了看笑话谁。如果好像我画 David 老师是不会用这个的，他都是这样子清洗就可以了。 Like for example, if I paint the teacher David Jensen's painting, basically he are not using here, he's not using this kind of brush top, he just clean the brush like that will do. Okay, so depends on what painting I'm following, okay, which teacher also. Okay, so you have to prepare a clean water, 你要准备一个干净的水桶，水你没有这个没有关系，你就用普通的水桶来装就可以了，小小的一个杯子也 OK. If you don't have this one, you just use a clean water, use a cup will do, OK? Then we will start painting this one. So also up to you if you want to sketch a pattern, you want to trace a pattern.然后呢，这个也是很个人的。如果呢是初学者呢，我就会我就比较建议初学者你可以先描图。For beginner, it's best for you if you can trace out the pattern. But to me, because I'm very familiar with the strokes, that's why I don't sketch, I don't trace the pattern. I can paint directly like that.因为我已经对那个笔法已经很熟悉很习惯，所以呢我基本上呢我都没有描图，我就直接这样子画。可是呢我觉得初学者你们有一个描了图呢，你会比较容易跟，然后你也你画的呢你可以跟着那个形去画呢，你就不会走出去那个范围，就对你来说会比较轻松。 So if for beginner, if you follow the sketching lineSo it will be much easier for you, okay, for beginner. So you have the line to follow. So usually you won't be out of the box, and sometimes you don't know where to start. So if you have the outline, then it's much easier for you. Then you will paint more relaxed also, okay? So for beginner, I advise you to sketch, to trace the pattern first. 所以呢初学者你最好呢你就是先把它描出来。这个图稿呢我会把它分享在描述栏的一个连接，你可以点击连接进去，然后你可以把它打印出来你要的尺寸，然后你就跟着画。This pattern I will share in the link below inside the description section. Then you can print out according to the size you want, then you can trace it. Okay, you can trace out and follow the pattern to paint. Now let us start painting. Okay.Just follow. So at first, I would like to use the green color liner brush. green color. You can have the moss green and the pine green. You can mix these two green to paint the leaves first. I will put my paint here so that you can see. 一开始呢，我喜欢用这个浅绿和深绿，就是苔藓绿和这个松绿先画叶子，很随性的 ，is very casual painting。我喜欢随性的画法 ，OK。I like this casual kind of painting. I don't like to follow sometimes very neat work. You see， 我不喜欢。我很喜欢，其实我很喜欢看别人的彩绘，他们画得很好，有一些画得很工整，我很喜欢。可是我自己呢，因为我的性格的关系，我不能够做很工整的东西。I like to see people paint some painting are very neat, very nice. I like to see, but I personally, because of my style and maybe because of my character,I myself cannot paint very neat kind of painting, okay? So that's why I don't like to trace. But it's very personalized, okay? You have to trace it. For beginner, I advise you to trace it. If you trace the pattern, then much easier for you. 只是因为我自己的性格的关系，所以呢，我不能够画得很工整的东西。所以我不喜欢描图，我很喜欢很随性的。但是呢，给初学者来说呢，我还是建议你最好你要描图，你跟着图稿来画会比较简单 ，OK？ 可是当你已经很有把握了，你的笔法都画得很好了，那么你不描图也没有关系。But if you after that you already painted very well, you master your strokes, then you no need to trace. It's fine, OK? Because you know your stroke well, OK? Then we change to.Filbert brush. 现在呢，我们把它换去这个椭圆笔。我先沾这个紫色。Okay, put on this whole brush with the purple color first. Then on top, just dip like that. White color. 只是这样子拿这个紫色。Okay, 我们先看一下这个花呢。它一共有1、2、3、4、5个笔法。They have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 strokes. This one is all common stroke.全部用的都是这个逗点笔法 ，OK。所以呢，我们先来第一笔呢是这样子，从这边回去中心点。当这边是中心点，你可以再拿过颜料。这边呢，第二笔比较大。The first one going to the center, we treat it a center here, OK. Then this center stroke can be slightly bigger. Then.Again, the same common stroke, but this one is one from the left to the right. This one is from right to the left. Go to the center. 也是回去中心点。然后我不转纸。I don't turn. I just from the bottom. I paint from the bottom. 我从下面往上。Okay? So you can practice. That's why you need to practice. If you are not familiar, you can, of course, you can turn. 如果你不熟悉，你当然你可以转你的纸。但如果你已经对你的笔法很熟悉了，其实你不用转纸，你也可以画得很好。OK， 你主要呢，你就是要学习笔法。OK， it's important that you learn the stroke. Then wash the brush again. We paint the second one. Same. Take the purple color first. Then the white color. Maybe I want another one here.Okay, if you found that the paint are not enough, you can take again. 如果你发觉颜色不够了，你可以再拿过。From the bottom to the center. 从下往上。Okay? 洗笔。再来。So you have to arrange where you want to paint it.所以你自己呢，你要铺排，你要在哪里？所以我们不会画的一条线。So we won't arrange like in a very static tree together. Some high, some low. 有一些比较高，一些比较低。那个呢，都要你自己去设计。Okay? Maybe here I want another one. 这边呢，我想要另外一个。你看是很快的。 It's very fast if you know your stroke. 如果你的笔法很纯熟了，其实画真的是很快，你就可以把一件作品完成了。所以你要把你的笔法先练好。So it's important that you have to practice your strokes, okay? Everybody can paint. 每一个人都可以画，就是看你花多长的时间在练习。Just depends on how much you spend on the practicing, okay? Okay? So maybe I want one more here. 我想这边画多一颗就可以了。你可以有不同的方向。You can do different directions, some facing here, some facing here, some straight. 你有一些是可能是像这里的，有一些像这里的，有一些是直的， OK? 都很随意。It's very casual, OK? No fixed rules. 没有一个真正的那个，我们的 rules 是叫什么？没有一个真正的规则。就是你喜欢就好了。Important is that you are happy with your project, OK? 主要呢就是你满意你自己的作品，你会开心。Like that, OK? Done. 这样子就足够了，我们不需要太多。No need to be too much, OK? Now, we have to blow dry first. 我们要吹干，因为要再画黄色。Before the yellow color, we have to blow dry first. Okay, I blow dry first. Then we paint the yellow color. Same, okay, you just look here, the color. Now I will take the yellow color first.Yellow, then white color, just dip like that, okay? Then only these two petals we need the yellow color overlapping. 只有这两个花瓣下面呢，我们需要黄色重叠， okay? 所以我们就从下往上，可以错开一点点的位置，不需要完全一样的位置。So the yellow can be slightly different position, okay? No need to be exactly. Okay? Very simple. Some lighter, some more yellow, some more white. It's up to you. 有一些可能比较黄，有一些比较白，都没有关系，很自由的。Wash the brush, 洗笔，然后用我们这个笔端 then we use the point, the end of the brush, we take the yellow and the white together, dot in the center. 然后呢，我们用这个笔端呢，拿黄和白呢，点中间，中心点，就是这样子。Okay, you see, done already, very simple, simple project. After that,现在呢，我们就用这个线笔 ，use the liner brush. Okay, take the pie green. We paint the center here. 好像有一个笑脸。We paint the center like a smiling face here. Okay, then also you can pine green mix with some of the moss green. Paint the stem.可以画它这个花茎。Okay, you see, very fast. 已经画好了。现在呢，我们就来画蝴蝶。Now let us paint the butterfly. Okay, butterfly, I like to use the S stroke. 我会用这个 S 笔法来画这个蝴蝶。先沾黄色。We will take the paint. Take the yellow first, whole brush.Then you can side load with the white color. 先单边呢，我们沾白色，先画这个 这个它的翅膀。We paint these wings first. Okay, this one is a stroke. Just push and leave another stroke, comma. 一个呢是 S 笔法，一个是逗点笔法。单边沾白。One side look with the white color. Okay? Then, this one have to slightly turn. Same, F, go to the center. 你这边要大概转一下你的这个纸张，你会比较容易。这边是中心点， here is the center. We always go back to the center. 我们要回去中心点。S, 一个 S 型，然后一个逗点。Okay? S and the comma.Then this one is the butterfly. Then here we just push from the inside, go out like that. Done already. 这样子就已经完成了一个蝴蝶。OK, 从这里往下推。OK, 如果这个你看不到很多白 ，we can redo if you cannot see the white so much. 你可以再做一次，这样子。OK, then we change to the liner brush, 换去这个线笔，拿青色。这个蝴蝶的身体 ，we paint the body. Okay, just like that. Very simple. 这样子就完成了一个蝴蝶，对不对 ？Okay, 你当然你可以换其他的颜色。Then we use, of course, you can change other color to paint this butterfly. Okay, just that I don't want to use other color. I just use whatever color I have here. 我只是用我这边我有剩下的颜色，然后这边也一样。So I want to paint another one here. Same, take the yellow color, then one side look with the white color. The white color facing up. 所以呢，这边呢，我画的时候呢，一样。白色呢会朝外，从这边画一颗 S, comma, OK, 然后再来稍微往下挪一点，这个呢 slightly go down here, OK, S go to the center, 一定要回去中心点 S, comma, OK, done already, right? Then, sorry.Use the same color, just here, push up, like that. Then change to the liner brush, take the green color, paint the body. Okay, 就是这样子。Then we can also paint some of the little flower. 我们也可以画一些小碎花。也是用黄色来画 ，then just use the same color yellow and white color to paint some of the little flower. Can mix with some water. 你可以加一点点水，比较容易画。就是很随性的 ，just very randomly here and there. 转上去。So you have to design yourself where you want to have this small little flower. 所以呢，你其实呢，你自己要自己设计。你看一下你哪里需要放这些小黄花 ，OK？ 就来的 done。我很喜欢这样子随性的画法 ，I like this kind of very casual painting, very relaxed and no stress. Okay, 这样子就完成了。这个我画的其实有点直 ，This one I painted a bit straight. Maybe you have to turn a bit. Okay, so the painting is very simple done already. 这样子就完成了。看，你可以把它画在不同的素材上，又简单又容易，而且你最重要是你其实你很有满足感，因为这个都是你自己创造出来的。所以呢，我们用眼睛可以看到美，而且最重要，我们可以创造美。最开心的就是这里了。So you can paint this one on any surfaces. Most important, we are happy because we can create beauty. because we look at this one, it's very nice, very happy, we are very satisfied. Most important, we can create this one by ourselves, by our own hand. Okay, hope you like my painting, hope you like my sharing. 希望你喜欢今天的分享咯，谢谢，谢谢收看， thank you for watching.